day to you, brothers and sisters. We are back again on part 4 of our series of Be the Bridge. And today, once again, you're going to watch a very interesting video on a young lady by the name of Mary Slezer. As you know, we are missionaries, so we love reading and being inspired by the lives of many missionaries out there. Mary Slezer was a person God used as a bridge to bring historical transformation to a nation. Be blessed as you listen to her life testimony. Mary Slezer was born in 1848 to a poor working class family. Her father was a shoemaker who was an alcoholic and lacked responsibility. Her mother was a skilled weaver who worked in the mills. At the age of 11, living in Aberdeen, Scotland, Mary began working after school to help provide for the family. At 27, she was called by God as a missionary to Nigeria, to a place called Calabar. Mary learned the Efik language and was used by God to spread Christianity, promote women's rights, and protect native children. She is most known for stopping the common practice of infanticide of twins in Okoyom. The belief of the native people at that time was that the birth of twins was an evil curse and that one of the infants was the devil's child. Unable to determine which one was evil, the natives would abandon both babies in clay pots to die. God used Mary Slezer as a bridge to bring revival. This is her story. It is the year 1873, and the pioneer to missions in Africa, David Livingstone, has just died. A great wave of missionary enthusiasm builds, and the call for workers in Africa spreads. One of those who answered the call was blue-eyed, ginger-haired young woman, Mary Slezer. There was, however, two problems. She was a woman and single. What could she really be able to do? At the age of 27, she left Scotland and set sail for the continent of Africa. Her eyes were open to the lives of the native people, their superstitious beliefs, and the darkness of witchcraft that surrounded every area. One day she prayed, "Lord, the task is impossible for me, but not for thee. Lead the way and I will follow." With newfound faith, she rose up saying, "Why should I fear? I'm on the royal mission and in the service of the King of Kings." This mission lasted 40 years, which took her to some of the deep and dark parts of the African jungle. She built relationships with village chiefs and the people, and also saved many infants from death due to witchcraft practices. She was also the first woman magistrate. She taught the gospel passionately from village to village. Mary was the first woman to appear on the Scottish £10 note. Because of her passion in serving God, she was also given the title Queen of Calabar. And to most people, she was known as Ma. This was one person who was daring, courageous, and bold to be the bridge. She once said, "Every woman has a mission to accomplish on earth. Not my plans, not my glory, but God's plans and His glory." Mary did not allow anything to hinder her from carrying out God's plans. We too should not allow any obstacles to prevent us from being the bridge. Her motto was, God plus one is a majority. The Bible is filled with countless verses on how we can be the bridge. Let each one of us look out not only for his own interests, but also for the interests of others. Philippians 2:4. Encourage one another and build each other up. 1 Thessalonians 5:11. Carry each other's burden, and in this way you will fulfill the law of Christ. Galatians 6:2.